Where the rock gets robbed.
No! I don't want to hear, like, if your game plan is based on the manipulation of rules and that's what you're relying on, save it. Here's a real simple thing for James Harden. I've been saying it all year. Hit your shots. Don't be looking for the referee to bail you out. Hit your shots. I want to play you something, Stephen A. Here's the shot that Harden took. Now, let's recall, the rule is simply that the defender must allow the offensive player a safe place to land. Mm-hmm. Take a look. Okay, freeze it right there. He didn't offer a safe place to land? So it looks like Draymond drifted forward a little bit. But let's watch the replay. Freeze it. Okay, there he is. He can come down. Let's look. He kicks his feet out underneath Draymond. That is intentionally done to manipulate the rules. And the refs wisely said, you had a place to land. You chose not to land there. You chose to land under the man's feet. And then Harden after the game has the nerve to be like, look what happened with Kawhi. Like, that was the same thing when Kawhi really didn't have a safe space to land. It was a dirty play by a dirty player, and it cost Kawhi. Yeah, and they weren't going to win in the postseason, but it cost Kawhi, like, real time. That's messed up. Harden's trying to say that's the same thing. That's messed up, because sometimes it is a dirty play. That wasn't one of them. It's like clockwork, Stephen A. They were coming down, and I get this on Twitter now. You're trolling Harden. The way the man that used to sit in this chair, people say, was trolling LeBron. I am not trolling James Harden. I'm not sitting here saying the die is cast. This is the way it's going to be. I'm saying these men write their scripts right now. First round doesn't count. Come on. Second round of the playoffs right now. You write your own script. Harden, what are you, as you would say, what you going to do? Comes down the court, steps out of bounds. Like clockwork, I can set my watch to it. But you know what? He has another chance. Hit the shot. If he's concentrating on canning the shot instead of getting the call, maybe that shot goes in and it's a tie game. Game on the line, hit the shot. Don't cry that the ref doesn't fall for your BS antics, sliding your feet under the guy to try to get a call. They were not robbed.
First of all, it's a couple of things. Number one, I totally agree with you in terms of them not being robbed. They were not robbed. James Harden did not deserve that call on that final play for exactly the reasons that you just articulated. And I'd also like to add, shooting 47 three-pointers ain't going to cut the mustard, okay, unless you're making them. So that's a D'Antoni thing. And last but not least, at some point in time, we're going to have to start talking. Somebody going to have to wake up and start talking about Kevin Durant, best player in the world. His brother's on another level.
Oh, we're gonna get
Let's
to that.
Be very, very clear about that. But I will go back to this. And to argue your point, I'm not arguing about the last play. There's nothing to debate there. James Harden did not deserve that call. They were not robbed. But I do think that you have to respect basketball players from this perspective. James Harden and Chris Paul are magicians at drawing fouls. There is no question that is undeniable. But the flip side to it is that Kawhi Leonard issue that James Harden addressed in the post-game news conference is very poignant. It's not applicable to the last play against Draymond Green, but it was applicable to at least three times, on at least three occasions in the first half when James Harden shot, and at least once or twice in the second half. There were about four or five occasions, and I'm not accusing anybody of Golden State for undercutting James Harden, intentionally trying to hurt him. What I am saying is they were jumping into the shooter. And when you look at it from that perspective, if you are a shooter, particularly one that gets elevation on your shot, let me tell you the one thing that concerns you more than anything else is somebody undercutting you. Because all you have to do is step on somebody's foot, you twist your ankles, which is why when he brought up Kawhi Leonard, it really should have resonated. Because that's legit. If you have, like, for example, Max, I remember when I was in college, you have a knee injury. Somebody even faking like they're going at your knee will make you jerk because you're scared to death. Well, even if you're not injured, if you are a shooter, particularly when you're seeing early in the game when somebody is launching and they're getting away with it, that's going to scare you as a shooter. If it was Steph Curry with his history of ankle injuries at the Oracle and shooters were jumping into Steph Curry like that, trust me,
but you
Steve
know what?
Kerr would go ballistic, Steph Curry and his teammates would be going ballistic, the crowd would be going ballistic, and the official would pay attention.
But you know what? Harden may be the victim of his own antics because the refs may be so alerted to the fact that he tries to pull that. Like, that's different than Chris Paul ripping through and when he sees Clay's, and they mentioned it on the broadcast, out of body position, right?
Right.
And drawing the foul. Yeah. That's a little different. That's a clever play.
Right,
but this is the refs going, James, and it's working against him now. James, we're not falling for that. So even sometimes when he should be getting the call, he's not because they don't want to give him those BS calls.
I agree with you. But again, you're talking about the last play. And I'm saying to you, if there are three or four or even five occasions earlier in the game, where there was reason for legitimate concern, that can scare the living hell out of you.
All right, let me get in there. They might not have been robbed, but clearly the officiating had a negative effect. Were you encouraged or discouraged by the Rockets' performance?
Discouraged by James Harden's performance.
Why?
Because he choked under pressure. I'm so sick of people saying, well, it's really hard in the playoffs because they defend you differently. Like, they defended Michael Jordan differently, and somehow he got better. Oh, you got to be Michael Jordan? Well, yes. James Harden has put up historic numbers in recent regular seasons.
You've compared him to Peyton Manning.
Oh, right. Only to collapse under pressure. And Clayton Kershaw in the postseason. Don't dribble. Don't step out of bounds before you shoot. Don't worry so much about drawing the foul that you don't hit the shot. Stephen A., if I saw James Harden hit that three, so it's not enough to take a good shot? No, it's not. You have to hit them in crunch time. Yes, they're not as good as the Warriors. To win, they need their MVP to play like it.
I was encouraged. Yeah? The reason why I was encouraged is because I think I'm about to get a series. Me think picking Golden State doesn't mean I don't want a series. I'd love a seven-game series, and I think this could go seven games. And yesterday showed it to me. James Harden shoots 25% from three-point range, 4 of 16. They still come within a basket of tying or potentially winning this game. Eric Gordon drops 27 points, but he shot 4 for 13. I think he shoots better from three as the series progresses. Chris Paul had 17 points, but they were a minus 7 with Chris Paul on the floor. That ain't going to last. You can't count on that happening. Capella, a minus 17 with him on the floor. Mm-hmm. I don't think that's happening again.
No,
PJ Tucker, no points, 0 for 4 from the field.